Well, let me bring my other guest now. Dr. Chima Anaji joins me in the studio. He's a legal practitioner and a political analyst. Thank you so much for joining us on the program.
Thank you, Sharon. Good evening, viewers.
Well, quickly, let me go to Mr. Femi Adesina, who has been with us on the program. Tell me, striking revelation, some of those things that we've heard the president talk about in the United States. But how serious exactly is the president on the issue that he mentioned on the CNN that he's not going to spare anybody? Does he really mean it?
Well, we know our president. We know the stuff he's made of. We know the stuff he's made of, and we know that no matter who the person is, if he's indicted of corruption, he will face justice.
Just a moment. Sorry to cut in there, but tell us, we understand, how true is it that there are about 30 members of his cabinet that were, that their names were sent for scrutiny, that only three of them made it out without any stain of corruption? How true is that?
No. I cannot, in all honesty, confirm that, because it's something that was just trending online. I doubt if it has any basis in reality.
Okay. Now, he told us that he has some documents that are going to be useful in getting these monies back. Give us an idea of the magnitude of this.
Yes, there was a meeting between a president and the attorney general of the U.S. And, of course, it dwelt mainly on how the United States can help Nigeria retrieve and repatriate these funds. It all began from a G7 meeting in Germany in June, when President Obama promised our president that America will help Nigeria to trace, recover, and repatriate stolen funds if Nigeria can make information available to the U.S. And we know, hearing from the president, that a lot of information is available now. People have made information available to government. Information that our president said earlier on were being verified. And by now, some of those have been verified and they can be passed on to the United States. Let me tell you what the Attorney General of the United States told our president, that the United States will help Nigeria to trace, recover, and repatriate funds, not only in America, but in all America's jurisdictions. Those were the words, in all America's jurisdictions. That means wherever America has influence, wherever it has treaty, wherever it has relationship, it can help us to get back funds. Okay. Like you said in your report, everything may not be got back, but then we know that a lot can be retrieved. The president himself said that the stolen funds are in billions of dollars. That's a lot of money.
All right. Just before I allow Ms. Dr. Inaji to come in into this matter, the PDP today made a statement, a strong one, and they say that most of what we have seen in the activities of the EFCC and some other anti-graft agency is a witch hunt by the Buhari government against the PDP allies.
I would have been very surprised if the PDP is applauding President Buhari and the APC government. You know, this was a government that threatened to rule us for 60 years. It could rule for only 16 out of that 60. It would be in the paroxysms of pain by now, because that party is learning to play in opposition. In its life, it had never been in opposition before. All the freebies are gone. They have to work for their money now. Definitely, they wouldn't applaud the party in government.
The PDP said today that APC government so far, no direction. What would you have to say to that?
They are certainly like broken record, because they've said that many times. Just like a broken record. That's how they are sounding.
But they are saying that most of what we've seen, that the president, the activities of President Buhari in the United States are somewhat what they regarded as an unsuccessful trip, in which most of the agenda there were not achieved. In fact, they said that the entourage, the people listed on the entourage with the president, they're not actually the kind of people that should be on that trip.
They were not there, so they wouldn't know. And don't also forget that under the PDP government, there was a meeting where they went with 150 people to the United States of America. There were just about 32 people on this trip. Compare that to 150 that went during the PDP rule. So you can compare.
All right, let me bring some issues home. Just a moment, Mr. Adesina, just stay with us. Let's allow Dr. Inaji to weigh in this matter. You're a lawyer, and of course I know that you've taken some graft cases up. We saw the EFCC being active in the couple of days on the past few weeks. What would you say is responsible for this resurgence of that agency?
Well, in the first instance, if the head is right, the other side, parts of the body will follow suit. And that is why some of us insist that this current president must work very hard and fast before the goodwill he has begin to dwindle. You understand what I mean? What is going for this president now is the way he has been presented as an anti-corrupt, person, somebody that is incorruptible, as they say, and somebody that is highly principled. Not much has been done. So it is that body language and the perception that is working now. Do you understand what I mean? So it is now incumbent on the president not to liquidate that goodwill that is running for him. Going straight to your question, the anti-graft agency, EFCC, there seem to have been activities during the time of Ribadu. Yes, they say it was selective because the president then was using that as an instrument of perhaps intimidation and all that. But I believe that you cannot intimidate somebody who does not have any skeleton in his cupboard. I don't know whether you get the point. So the issue is not so much whether you are threatening opponents and is the opponent guilty? So that next time, when it comes to the turn of the people who have sympathy for that man who has been perhaps exposed, he will expose the other group. Do you get the point? And for that, the society will be better.
Give us an idea of what you make of the trend of the kind of prosecutions that we've seen in the past few days. We've seen that the former governor of Adamawa State, we've seen the former governor of Jigawa State. Now we understand that the wife of the former governor of Kwara State and the current Senate president has been invited. Mm. From what the allegations are on the table, that this looks so much like a witch hunt. Do you really think so?
Many of these people have had these problems, even under the past government, even in the previous administration of Obasanjo. Some of them had had problems. You understand? It is just that the lethargy in the anti-graft agency, I must say that, because there was so much of lull in the activities there, either because there was some political interference in the activities and somebody in that position did not have the balls to take the steps or resign. Do you understand? Because people must have principle to speak for them.
So, but do you think...
So, what is going on now, whether it is witch hunt or not, the fundamental question is, are these people being fingered? Do they have any question to answer? Do you understand them? I'll give you a simple...
Just a moment, before that. In law, it is said that you're not just going to be fair, but you must be seen to be fair in whatever you are doing. Because Nigerians don't want to...
The fair in law is about the right for the person to hear a fair hearing. You understand? The anti-graft agency is not a court. It is bound, if it has anything against anybody, to take the person to court. And that person will have his day in court, his or her day.
So what has changed between the last time, the last administration, and now? Is it the gut or what?
I don't think that is the gut. It is that they believe that the man that has taken over have been presented as having a negative attitude towards corrupt tendencies. You understand? Remark my word, perceived We want to see the perception put into action. Do you understand what I mean? And that's why I'm insisting that the president must act fast and well in order not to liquidate or fritter away the goodwill, the tremendous goodwill. The American president himself appears to have related to him very positively on account of his belief that is clean of corruption. And we had what he said in Kenya, his home, well, somehow, his father's land, land of birth. You understand? So corruption is iniquity. I mean, let's not use an elegant word. It's iniquity. Right. And when you are iniquitous, you smell, you stink.
Tell me, what do you make of President Buhari's trip to the United States? If you are going to summarize that trip, would you say it was a successful one?
Well, I want to use the word successful very advisedly. You understand? I want to use the word hope. It gives hope. Do you understand? Because what has happened now is that it has given us the hope that something positive will happen. Because Nigeria has now been placed on a more positive perception. You know, just like when some big people are in the stadium, some young people rush to them and take photograph with them and place it in either in their corner. So people will say, ah, you know this man, you know. So that perception is what we have now. But to get that hope into fruition, we must address some of internal issues we have. We cannot hope that the man next door will always give us lunch when we don't have the raw food. We can have the raw food and ask for gas.
So PDP may be correct by saying that there's not been so much action with this government.
I wouldn't want to see it from the PDP or political angle. I'm talking about a Nigerian citizen that is interested in the progress of this country. Nigerians are suffering. All right.